Well, good evening. Welcome to Wednesday night's live Scapes. Thank you for tuning in. I think we've got everything working. We're doing 13 weeks of these 3 nights a week. And this is, I believe, week 7, if I've done my math, which frankly I didn't, but feels like we're about in the middle. At least it seems that way from the amount of bugs that we've encountered. Very, very fun to learn, especially when trying to accomplish something that is delicate. Anyway, I think that we are actually slowly making some improvements, and I know that I've really appreciated the honor of working on this challenge. It's really, I think, a moment where we need to get imaginative about how we can help each other and create a sense of not only safety, but support within the context of safe. And this means, of course, reaching into that question of how can I understand the needs, the necessities of both myself more deeply and of others. So with that in mind, if you're having an experience with these things, feel free to fill out the feedback form and be entered into a raffle for those who enter feedback. I believe there's one more week to go, and we'll be picking at the end of next week for a box of delicious McCrae's caramels. I recently spoke to our last winner of the McCrae's caramels, and he confirmed very, very sincerely that both he and his two boys did believe that these could quite possibly be the very most delicious caramels that exist on the planet. Anyways, from what I can tell, it looks good. I don't know if anyone's out there and wants to send me a text, but I feel like we should be settling in. Sometimes I talk a bit to allow people a moment. Plus, one of my bits of feedback said that I had a, I think, voice that could be hashtagged as a soft voice. And so perhaps that is also healing in its own right. I don't know. If I do have a soft voice, it might be because we were doing taiko drums today with the children I teach at the Montessori school. And it took quite a bit of vocalizing to bring some sense of process and order to the situation. Anyways, assuming that we are all here and settling in, we'll begin with an activity of guided awareness, focusing on this week's theme. And one of the interesting things that's happened in my work with the children is learning that in our sensory experience, we tend sometimes to process time and space through separate parts of our intelligence. And certainly these two aspects of existence do have different and unique qualities, but they are also not separate. And so sometimes using an awareness of spatial boundaries can also generate a sense of a temporal boundary. And this can help us to settle in and understand that the moment we're in now is not the moment we were in. And quite possibly, because of this boundary, we could make this moment a preparation for something in the future, a kind of responding to the future. So, perhaps with these thoughts in mind, we begin first just to be where we are and notice the different ways that our awareness might be drawn. And from here, just to notice the boundary of our skin. And some of the skin will be in contact with clothes and under the pressure of gravity against whatever's supporting us or not. And some will be in contact with the air. But our skin is our boundary of our body. And so without drawing a judgment about that, just to be aware of that spatial boundary as a pure spatial experience. As best you can. And from here, to be aware of what you might call personal space or one's atmosphere. This field. Perhaps it's defined by what you could reach, or perhaps by what you notice as a boundary between yourself and others at different moments. And to allow that boundary to breathe and expand. Let your field take up a little more space. And then to notice the boundary of the room. Again, without judgment, it's a pure spatial experience. As it exists right now. returning to this boundary of the body, to go a bit within. We notice our thoughts and our feelings and the flow of life in the body. Without judgment, but as having a space. And then perhaps even deeper within, perhaps to a heart of hearts.